Introduction regarding the embedded system. So, coming to the embedded system, first of all, we need to know some basic idea regarding the. So, what is the system? So, system is nothing but some collection of things which are used to perform some command effects. That means what you say is system is a collection of things which will do the some basic events which are operated based on some principles and everything. So that means system is a based on the which there you can say right here is a collection of things which follows a procedure. To do the events, and finally we will get the some functionality. So these are the three things we need to decide whenever we are talking about a system. It should have the collection of things which have the some individual aims and everything. Then by collecting all these things, we need to follow some procedures, some principles, everything, and based on this we need to attain some functionality. This is what a system means, a basic system. And coming to this system is classified into two types. Since if we come with some electronic background, what we can say, system is can be classified into two types. One is the general purpose other one is the application. This is the basic level of classification for any type of system. Because system, what in the earlier we have shown that system is used to combine the things, to follow some procedures and to give some functionality. And this system, we have the two basic classifications, general purpose system and application specific system. The general purpose system involves the functionality in a general manner. That means it is not defined to do only this set of operation. That means a general specific system have some hardware entities from where we can do majority of operations which we can do in our real life. That is what the general purpose of the system is. That means we can do some basic calculations, basic operations, some functionalities like some CPU. The best example of a general purpose system is our computer, personal computer, some CPU, all of these. That will come under the general purpose system. And come to the application specific system, this will also have some hardware entities will be there, and using these we can do only some specific operation computer, application specific system. But coming to the general purpose system, it can do the operations whatever can be done by this one, but this can be do only the specific operations. That is the thing in the general purpose system and the application specific system. And the other name for this application specific system is the embedded system. Embedded system. So an embedded system is an application specific system. That is a brief point we have to discuss. Embedded system. If we go with the elaboration in specific, embedded system. So first of all, whatever the system may be, we have told it should be a collection of things. So based on inspiration, what we can say is embedded system contains some things. Embedded system also it is a system. It is having some collection of things. What are the things? Hardware. Similarly, since it is a system, you should have to follow some procedures. What is the procedure? Software. And it needs to attain some functionality. That is what the defined operation it needs to do. So the things is nothing but the hardware, and the procedure what need to follow is nothing but the software. And finally, you need to obtain some functionality, which is nothing but the operational unit output. So, on the overall, what we can say define an embedded system is, it is a combination of software and hardware, which using which we can do some specific operation or a specific set of operations. This is what a brief definition of the embedded system. So based on this background, we can go with the further discussion. So just now what we have told is the embedded system is nothing but a combination of hardware and software, and using this hardware and software combination we can realize some operations, or we can realize some specific set of operations. That is what. So it is a application specific system, because it is used to realize only some specific application or a specific set of applications. We can see that you can have a lot of applications are there, like ATM machines, mobile phone, some card readers, barcode, like this. We have some different types of applications are also there with respect to the embedded system. And normally the digital cameras, etc. So we have some lengthy list of the embedded systems are there in our day-to-day life, where we can have regular applications are there. So without this embedded system, we cannot imagine our daily life. This is what the significance of the embedded system. So these are some JCL specific applications.